Huntsville's Marshall Space Flight Center is putting the final touches on its contributions to the Artemis II program.
Yeah, what these folks do is just beyond anything to me. This next mission will allow a crew of four astronauts to orbit the moon. News 19's Kayla Smith brings us an update from some of the North Alabama engineers working to one day return humans to the lunar surface.
This piece of hardware is packaged up and ready to be shipped to Kennedy Space Center in Florida. This is the final piece of hardware that Marshall will contribute to the Artemis II mission.
The Orion stage adapter is a 5-foot-tall adapter that sits right above the ICPS of SLS and right below the European service module.
The stage adapter makes up 5 feet of the 322-foot-tall space launch system, and it was designed and manufactured in its entirety at Marshall Space Flight Center. The adapter separates the astronauts from the rest of the rocket's propulsion systems. It will stay with the capsule as the crew leaves lower Earth orbit.
We are getting ready to go. Once this leaves for the Cape next week, it'll be stacked onto the rocket once it's loaded with its CubeSats, and all you have left is this portion of the rocket to go for the stack and should be ready to fly.
The Orion stage adapter is also designed to carry CubeSats, which are shoebox-sized satellites. They should deploy about 5.5 hours after launch, measuring data like radiation levels. On Redstone Arsenal, Kayla Smith, News 19.
The Artemis II is scheduled to launch next spring.